Good evening. Sometimes it really does happen. Today was one of those occasions when, around about 4 o'clock, we knew we were going to have a combination of football matches that will be hard to beat all season. It then got even better. So we not only have a barrel load of goals for you, but football that comes right out of the top draw. Added to which, we had filmed cameras at Murrayfield, where the score for one side alone was more than 8 English batsmen could muster in the last Test match. This is what you might call one of the quieter moments at Pittodrie.
Have got to come back. Hamilton and McCloy. McMaster off the line, but Strachan all through his legs. How did it stay out?
Oh yes, a great game to behold. Tonight, we make the draw for the Indoor World Bowls Championships, which became so popular last year.
He has the final delivery of this quite remarkable 19th end.
And Murrayfield was the place to be if you're a devotee of running rugby. Edinburgh ran in no less than 11 tries. This is one of them. It counted all right. Not such a high score at the Stamford Bridge game today, but it sent the purists home raving.
There are only 5 players actually not in the 18-yard area. And it was Timmons, and off the line by Bradley.
And if you've been puzzling all week over last week's Hit the Headline competition, remember Paradise Lost at San Siro? We'll have the answer for you later in the programme. We'll also draw the 3 winning cards and then test your memory once again with another sporting headline.
Well, certainly my family didn't get it right. Although Aberdeen is the only all-seated stadium in British football, such was the quality of the game today that, in truth, most spectators spent their time on their feet. Nobody was complaining, though not the least our commentator. The Aberdeen Rangers match, Alistair Alexander. Well, at the moment, we don't have sound from the Aberdeen game. It was a remarkable game at Pittodrie today. If I say any more about it, it'll give the game away. Doogie was saying that the competition, Paradise Lost at San Siro, will be revealed towards the end of the programme, and there's no question about it. We had some remarkable entries. Some of them were wrong, of course. Stephen Quinn from Kamana gave his version that the bleak evening in 1970. I think we've now got the game, are we? Well, at the moment, we are not quite sure whether we can get the Aberdeen game or not. I think I'd better find out if we can. Yes, I see. Okay, fine. Sorry about that. We have got this marvellous game ready, thankfully, at long last.
Aberdeen are without captain Willie Miller, who's under SFA suspension, and they show one change from the side that lost 1-0 to Morton last week. Ian Scanlon comes back after being dropped following the League Cup final, and Stuart Kennedy is captain. Steve Archibald, Aberdeen's top scorer with 8 goals this season, but he hasn't found the net since Aberdeen last beat Rangers in the league, and that was at Ibrox. Well, with top scorer Derek Johnson also under suspension, Derek Parlane keeps his place in the Rangers team at number 9. And Rangers haven't won a league match at Pittodrie for over 5 years, and manager John Gregg hopes to remedy that position with this team. Cooper and Smith are the substitutes, and Sandy Jordan continues as captain. Bob Valentine of Dundee is the match referee. Stuart Kennedy won the toss for Aberdeen, so Rangers kick off attacking the goal to our right, the traditional Aberdeen end, the beach end, and immediately the ball funneled back all the way to McCloy. John McDonald immediately challenged by Strachan. McLeish to Considine. both teams showing a lot of respect for each other, pulling men back into defence. Now Strachan, Aberdeen midfield general, couldn't feed it past Gregor Stevens. McLean screaming for it on the right and getting it. Well, it was a little bit too quick for him. McLean certainly was in the clear. Stevens should have placed his pass better. John McMaster. Archibald being closely shadowed and a little too closely. Dawson giving away the first free kick of the match to Aberdeen. The foul on Archibald. Very dangerous position. Master curling it into the box. Forsyth getting away on his first track. And oh, great goal! Brilliant goal by Gordon Strachan. The free kick in by McMaster, headed over Forsyth, and it was Strachan's finish past McCloy. And Aberdeen, after 1 minute 20 seconds of play, take the lead. Aberdeen's 10th goal against Rangers this season in this their four matches played, and now we're into the fifth. Rangers have only scored one, and Aberdeen showing right away that they mean business. Back. Dawson keeps his head, tries to distribute it, find John McDonald. Cleish was there. Gardner giving Clark a touch of it. Rugby pumping it into the middle. Oh, Hamilton doing well to beat Jackson. Darnell's header. Stephen trying to turn the tide for Rangers, but back come Aberdeen. Rangers giving away possession of the ball. Nice, skillful build-up from Aberdeen. Cleish. McMaster. Hamilton didn't quite get it. Chance for Scanlon, though. Oh, fizzing! And Archibald, right at the end of it, got a touch and touched it wide. Well, that was as skillful a build-up as you could expect to see. The ball sweeping forward from midfield, eventually breaking to Scanlon. His fizzing low cross just touched by Archibald, but wide. Well, Aberdeen certainly on their mettle. And at the moment, Rangers making the mistakes, Aberdeen cashing in on them. Strachan just gliding through. Archibald back to Strachan, 1-2s, and Aberdeen making it look also easy. Well, Jordan electing to take the goal kick. Two Rangers players going for it. Gardner and Rigby look to be in the mood for Aberdeen. Clark immediately starting a counter-attack. Kennedy. Hamilton winning the throw-in. Cleish taking over, now Strachan. Rugby giving himself a little bit of room. Archibald and Hamilton, chance for McMaster, but he snatched at it. He had time to steady up there. And McCloy was certainly annoyed with his defence there, because it was poor covering that gave McMaster an excellent chance there, and he snatched at it. Touch by Parlane, John McDonald. Russell making a break through the middle, McLean's free on the right. Aberdeen again getting men back. Legs of Considine. Jordan. Considine again. McLean, three Rangers men in the box. Parlane trying to knock it on. John McDonald there, but is it given? Yes! John McDonald equalises for Rangers. The referee hesitated. Rangers player injured, but the goal will count. McLean's cross into the box. Parlane seemed to nod it into the air. The Aberdeen defence stood still, and John McDonald went in, certainly with the foot up, but he made contact and two-ended it past Clark. Well, John Gregg, the Rangers manager, obviously, after losing such an early goal, must be pleased that his men are back in this game when it looked as if Aberdeen were about to swamp them. Oh, nice bit of skill by the youngster. And a fine ball too, but Rugby saw the danger as Russell made again a telling run. Jackson pushing clearly that time on young Derek Hamilton. If we kick to Aberdeen, Strachan. Emphasised, but Strachan following up, getting it a second time. Hamilton, oh, and it was deflected away. McCloy certainly was going down, but that could just as easily have been deflected into the net. A heart-stopping moment for Rangers, and Derek Hamilton very nearly getting on the score sheet. Corner to Aberdeen. The first corner of the match, just coming up to the 20-minute mark, and it's a poor win by Strachan. And Archibald and Forsyth tangling off the ball. But untidy. Rangers get possession really out of nothing. Alex MacDonald. Parlane is covering a lot of ground. Russell, McLean's free in the right. Jarden making a run too. Again, Jarden going down, but again, McLean coming in. Chance for Rangers here. McLean tries to slant it in the corner, and Clark was helpless. A brilliant bit of work there by Tommy McLean. The pass from Russell setting off Jarden. Jarden seemed to take a dive. The ball broke to McLean. He played to the whistle or the absence of it. Brilliantly sidestepped, tried to place it in the corner, and Clark was slithering helplessly. Stevens winning that one in the air, midfield for Parlane. Dawson to Alex MacDonald, but Strachan was determined. Rangers gained ground. Checked again. Another throw. Russell this time. Well, the Aberdeen fans and players think that should have been their throw. Archibald. Hamilton, McMaster doing good job. Now Scanlon, a chance to attack. Cutting inside, gap opening up, and his shot wasn't far away. Well, it's that sort of typical skill there from Scanlon, a fine carving run and a flashing shot which really rouses the fans. Sliding off Rugby's head, but Garner doing a super job. Push Forsyth on Archibald. Forsyth literally sticking closer to Archibald than his jersey. And there should be just time for this free kick to be taken. We're inside the final minute in the first half. Meister driving it low into the box. Hamilton, Scanlon! this one, the direct shot might have paid off if the Rangers defence opened, and even at that, Archibald might have got a touch as he flashed in from the other side. So they throw two Rangers, no time to take it. The first 45 minutes are up, and quite a match at Pittodrie. Aberdeen, a great start, a goal by Gordon Strachan after 80 seconds, looked all set to sweep Rangers aside. Rangers rocked but didn't give in, and John McDonald equalised 10 minutes later, and the game's certainly in the balance now. Aberdeen get the second half underway, and these games between Aberdeen and Rangers always jam-packed with incident, and we've got another 45 minutes to come. First free kick of the second half given against Alex McDonald. Either side using their substitutes so far. Scanlon had come inside. Jordan with the throw for Rangers. Scanlon picks up the ricochet, slips Jordan beautifully. Good start for Aberdeen, and McMaster driving it over. Aberdeen trying to hit Rangers with another quick one right at the start of the second half. McMaster not all that far away. Far lane pushed from behind by Rugby. Jardine waiting for Colin Jackson to go up into the penalty area. Stevens, Parlane and Jackson all at the far side making their run in. Oh, and that was touched back by Garner. Happy to see that one safe in Bobby Clark's hands. John McDonald. He says no, accidental. Dawson having a good match. Oh, great run now, John McDonald. Rugby trying to close him down. Did well. McDonald waiting in support, arriving. And then McLeish, safety first. As Parlane was waiting to pounce. Tommy McLean with the throw-in for Rangers. Aberdeen marking tightly. McDonald, a fine weighted pass to Tommy McLean. Dangerous cross. Stevens was in and Clark in trouble. And that's corner. Clark protesting. Mr. Valentine turns his back, waves Aberdeen's claims away. Corner to Rangers. John McDonald swinging it high. Clark just gets a touch. Kennedy out. Aberdeen defence getting out as McDonald plays it along the ground to McLean. Great header from Jackson! Four minutes into the second half. Bobby Clark beaten at his right hand. Colin Jackson's header is absolutely spot on, and Rangers are ahead 2-1. The perfect cross and the perfect finish from the head of Colin Jackson. And Rangers, at one stage, looked to be in dreadful trouble against Aberdeen, who looked to be in top gear. Rangers have fought back with great determination and spirit. And now the initiative must rest with them. And Aberdeen have got to come back. Hamilton and McCloy. McMaster off the line, but Strachan, all through his legs. How did it stay out? Aberdeen, how could they miss that chance? The ball seemingly bound for the net, through Strachan's legs, and Hamilton just couldn't get it in. Scanlon, a quick snapshot, raises his eyes skywards in despair. Lane and a good run by Jardine. Gardner spotted it though. Hamilton to McLeish. Gordon Strachan.